Here we have a standard kind of Westminster movement. This one happens to be from Ergo's. Got everything out of it. They're being cleaned up in the ultrasonic right now. This is a UW32001B made by Ergo's. It's got a little problem, which you don't see too often, but when you do see it, you kind of cringe. Look at that minute arbor. That arbor has seen better days. Let me see if I can get you a close-up of it. Now most of the bend is taking place from this point forwards, but there is a slight bend that's happening right where the plate is on the inside. Now, normally you would look at that and say, well, how on earth am I going to straighten that out inside there? Because you can't really get that arbor out from between those plates. This pinion does not come off, which means that you do need to take off this guy here. And to go through all that trouble just to straighten out that little bend, I really wouldn't bother with that because we can pretty much straighten out this minute arbor. Oh, by the way, this clock was running with the arbor bent so crazy. And it's got a generous amount of play in it. It does not have a moon gear, which is good. If it had a moon gear, we'd probably have to straighten it all out because the moon gear would be way out over here. And it would fluctuate quite a bit from that bend down deep. So what we're going to do is to straighten out this particular arbor. I'm going to find what I need to grasp this guy. I don't think my stakes have got a hole big enough to eat up all this arbor here. Also, I need to figure out, is this particular arbor, where is the bend? It kind of looks like the bend is taking place from this point forwards to this gear and right in this area. So the rest of it's straight. So make sure that when you straighten it out that you're straightening out the bend and not just putting another bend on a bend. You don't want to do that. Sure does have a lot of play in there. But it doesn't have to be accurate, it's just moving the hands. It's also releasing the strike. It'll probably work just great without having to risk taking this off and snapping the entire assembly. So I'll be right back with the tools.
Is use a smooth jaw, parallel jaw plier.
I don't have any tools, including socket holes that go in there, because if I was to slide this guy on here like this and torque it one way or the other, it's going to put a lot of sideways pressure way up here, and it might put a bend in this area right here, although it may not. But why take a chance? I'm just going to be grabbing it with the parallel jaw plier and apply pressure where I need it. First thing you do is you just mark the high side. Not that it's so hard to see, but in case you overbend, then you also need to know that as well. I'm going to be marking the high side first. I have to hold it so I see it. This minute arbor also has a little detent or a shallower area kind of cut in it, right in the center here. So the snail wheel assembly, when it slides on here, it does not rub over here at all. It only rubs on this end and this end. That's another reason why you should never put oil in here, because the oil will get trapped in this little recess and it'll develop a hydraulic lock. And it'll just drive you crazy just trying to find it, because it'll come and go. I've had one lock so bad that I needed to take a plier to pull off the snail wheel assembly. And once I got it off, it just slid on and off very easily. Sounds like my dog wants to go for a walk. You definitely want to use a smooth jaw plier, because the teeth on a regular plier would mess up these bearing surfaces tremendously. Hopefully we didn't mess them up. I don't feel anything. It's got a little wiggle jiggle in the center there, but it's running pretty true now. Finger there. You see that little wiggle jiggle? But all in all, it's running a lot truer than what it was before. So I can't test it with the snail assembly. That's inside the ultrasonic right now. Okay. Oh, that was it. Sorry it was so easy.